Today we're going to be taking a look at some of the best Scratch hacks. So let's get started. The first hack is how to make the Scratch website more interesting. So we'll just come to the link over here and at the end, add.host. And then you'll be transported to this website and just look how cool it is. We got these effects about us and it just looks way better than normal Scratch. Okay, now on to the next one. So if we go to our costumes and we go to fonts, we can see these boring fonts. And some of them just look really bad. Like, what is this? Why did they even add this? They could have added any font, but they decided to do this. Well, don't worry, because if we just exit this project, let's go back to Scratch and just search up more fonts, then it will be transported to this page. So for example, let's click on this one. We can see a bunch of fonts and you might be thinking, well, this is just a picture. And for example, let's just change the Scratch font here, which is the same font Scratch uses, of course. Let's just say subscribe and you can see I'm typing and it's typing. So you can just use it in your projects instead of these fonts, bro. These fonts, just look how bad they are. Would you rather have this or this? Let me know down below. Okay, so the next one is also right here in the editor. We'll go to code. Let's just make a new sprite and let's just make it a black box. Center it. Okay, now this one is how to make custom events. So for example, we have one space key pressed and stuff like that, but we don't have one for if the mouse is touching. If you really want to do that, you would need to use a forever block, you would need to use a touching mouse pointer and all that business. But if you want to use the events block, well, it's actually pretty simple. Just take a one loudness block and let's change it to timer. Then we'll take the timer from here, get out the minus. And right here, it has to be something that's 1 or 0. So for example, let's take out touching mouse pointer. And if we're doing that, let's hide. Okay, so you can see we did it and it hid. And yeah, that's just custom events. Okay, so this one isn't as much of a hack as it is pretty funny. So if we go here, let's say text-to-speech and let's say speak poop. You can see it says nothing. But now if we do emoji, and we pick the poop emoji and my laptop is lagging. Okay, and you can see it worked. So yeah, so our next hack is how to follow yourself, and it's pretty easy. So you'll need to have an alt account and you'll need to go to your profile on one tab, and on the other tab you need to be on your homepage. And if you're already following your alt account, just unfollow. Okay, so now you're gonna go to your other tab and you're gonna sign out and you're gonna sign back in into your real account. Okay, now that you're back in here, you'll see on your other account, it still shows you. So here you can press follow. And then when you reload, it shows that it's you and you're following yourself. Okay, now related to this, let's see who unfollowed us. So right now, I unfollowed myself, so I should be able to see that. And all you need to do is search up who unfollowed me Scratch. And here it is. So what's the username? The Phantom Animator. And just get. And you can see it's loading, so it's gonna take a bit. And shout out to Dreg or Strower in Scratch. Sorry if I pronounced that wrong. Almost halfway there. Okay, and here we are, so we can see everybody who unfollowed me. So because of that glitch I just did, it says I unfollowed myself, but I'm still following myself. And you can see 200 users, they all unfollowed me. And I even remember this guy. I remember these people. Okay, so why did these guys unfollow me? If you see your username on here, then follow me again. And follow me on YouTube too. And if you like this video, you like this Scratch Hacks video too.